in the face. Now what? How do you condone that?
Here comes the Hunter.
Oh yeah!
I can't believe it. Andre is still on his feet, but maybe not for long. Hook brings him out to the middle of the ring now. Winds up and gets a Sunday punch,
and he still can't knock him down. The Giants rocking and reeling, and Hogan back to the eyes. What a cheap shot, McMahon. What a cheap shot.
Wait a minute. The hooks are going out to the outside. He's going up. What's he going to do? He's going up to the top rope.
Andre caught him.
Andre the Giant caught him from the top rope. What a body slam.
Whoa. Hogan made a tremendous mistake there.
Headbutt submission. The Giant missed with a headbutt.
It took the Giant to knock himself off his feet. Both men are injured right now. Hogan better go for a cover. Even though he went to the throat, he had to do something.
Another chokehold. Right down on the mat. Referee Dave Hebner warning Andre the Giant about that chokehold. He broke just in the nick of time, and he's right back on top of it.
That's right, but he's doing it smart. He's got the count of five. You can see how smart Andre is. Hogan has made a mistake now. The match has shifted in Andre's favor.
Right-handed knock the Hulkster down. Right back up he comes. In the back area. Ah, Andre.
Oh, he stamped on his hand. Well, that's payback for all those raking of the eyes Hogan did.
A scoop and a slam.
Look at how Andre manhandles Hogan.
Oh, no. Right into the midsection. Kick to the back again.
The
Andre
tide
trying to manhandle the Hulkster.
The tide of this match has changed tremendously. Hogan started extremely fast, but now it's all in Andre's corner.
Oh, what a shot.
I can feel it, McMahon. The champ is going to go down.
Hulkster down again. Andre just pouring it on. Backs the Hulkster to the corner now.
Whoa.
Another shot.
Equally both ways.
Andre with a Hulkster trying to set him up. And indeed, whipping to the rope. Big foot to the chest. And Andre goes down as well. The Hulkster to the outside. Wait a minute. Oh, come on.
Virgil's going to help him back in. See, you know why he did that, McMahon? Because as happened earlier, you can't win the title on a countout. They don't want no countout. They want a pinfall in the middle of that ring.
Yes, he has to see that. Come on, give me a break. As you said before, Hebner doing a good job thus far.
Well, you know, you got to remember something. Hebner only weighs about 150 pounds, you know. It's tough for Andre to listen to somebody that small.
Million-dollar man looking on. He certainly appreciates what the Andre, what the Giant is doing to the Hulkster. Andre again with a choke. Wait a minute. Break. And right back with more. What's this?
Andre trying to choke him out. Hogan's fighting his way up. I can't believe the strength of Hogan.
This is an eastbound. Hogan broke the hold. Knee to the midsection. A chop to the throat. Another one. Andre back to the corner. Hulkster hammering it to the forehead. Break of the face again. Hulk, what's he doing now?
He made that mistake earlier. Why is he going up
the second
again?
Rope. What's going to happen? Close line. The Giant goes down. for the leg. Wait a minute, Virgil. Virgil grabbed his ankle. Referee staying. Here comes the Hulkster. Yes. Covering. One, two, three,
no.
Four.
Virgil's got the referee tied up. Dave Hepner is over there warning Virgil.
Give me a break. Come on, referee. Turn around. Hulkster had Andre to track. Pin. One, two, three. He had him. Each other. Move on the right hand.
but Hogan is not allowed to manhandle referees like this.
I don't believe that man's a legal official. Dave Hebner.
What are you talking about?
Official.
He just did the math. How could he not be an official?
Hulk Hogan. And I don't know whether... Oh, wait a minute. Coming back. Oh, look at this. Whoever that man is, he's high above the air. The Hulkster knows. Look out. Oh.
Whoa. Hulk Hogan throwing the imposter referee right at Ted DiBiase, the million-dollar man, whom we had an occasion to talk with sometime after the match that same night. Let's take you now to the pre-recorded interview, Ted DiBiase and Andre the Giant.
Do you see it? Do you see where it is? Right there where I told you it'd be. I told you people that I always get what I want, by hook or by crook, and I told you I would be the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion, and look where it's at, Hogan, thanks to this man right here. I am the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion. That's right, Hogan. I told you. And I will not be a champion like you are. I will be a true champion all the way up and all the way down. No, I don't plan on coming down. But look at the way you did it, Hogan. Can you imagine this man going out and paying the money? You say everybody's got a price. What kind of money you think Hogan had to spend to go out and get a Dave Hebner look-alike referee to come out in the ring and try to confuse the issue? Try to confuse the issue, but it's not going to work, Hogan. It's not going to work because here the title is and here the title will stay. Long reign Ted DiBiase, the million-dollar man, the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion.
What outlandish and preposterous remarks made by the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase.
Now, how can you say something like that?
We had an occasion to pick up and record Hulk Hogan's comments as they happened live that night right after the match. Here's the Hulkster.
How much money did they spend on the plastic surgery, man? I had all bases covered. I had the Hulkamaniacs watching DiBiase. I had Virgil in his place. Never in my wildest dreams, Mean Gene, would I think that I would get ripped off by a penny pinching two-timing referee. How much money on the plastic surgery? How much money did he spend to pay the referee off? When I turned around, Mean Gene, they were identical. Identical.
Right here, Hulk. Here it is now.
Look at the shoulder, brother.
There.
Look at the shoulder.
That's him.
The referee is paid off, brother. Look at the $100 bill falling out of his pocket.
I know you're disappointed, Hulk Hogan.
Now that's outlandish and preposterous if you ask me.
Well, no one asked you, Jesse, but right now we're going to take you to the World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney for his long-awaited comments on his week-long investigation of the Hulk Hogan-Andre match.
February 5th, 1988 will go down in World Wrestling Federation history as a day of infamy. Never before has there been such controversy to surround a World Wrestling Federation championship match. Despite having viewed time and again videotapes of the Hogan-Andre match, the decision of the referee is, as always, unfortunately, final. Therefore, Hulk Hogan is not the World Wrestling Federation champion. However, it clearly states in the rule book that in order for a wrestler to be deemed a champion, he must either pin the reigning title holder or make him submit. That is the only way a wrestler can become champion. Therefore, unequivocally, I can state that Ted DiBiase is also not the World Wrestling Federation champion. Furthermore, it also clearly states in the rule book that a reigning champion may at any time in his tenure end his reign by publicly surrendering the title, which is exactly what happened when Andre the Giant presented the championship belt to Ted DiBiase. Therefore, Andre is also not the champion either. It is my decision that to be fair to the last two reigning champions of record, Hogan and Andre, and to furthermore be fair with the number one contenders who would have faced either Andre or Hogan as champion, I now declare the title vacant, and this vacancy to be filled on March 27th of this year during WrestleMania 4 in the form of the first ever World Wrestling Federation Championship Tournament. In this championship tournament, the last two title holders of record, Hogan and Andre, will justifiably be given a bye for the first round of competition. They will not compete in the first round, but will face each other in the opening of the second round of the tournament. The pairings have been completed for the first round of the competition, and they include Jake the Snake Roberts meeting Ravishing Rick Rude, Don the Rock Morocco taking on Dino Bravo, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat will wrestle Greg the Hammer Valentine, Randy Macho Man Savage goes against the Natural, Butch Reed, Bam Bam Bigelow against the One Man Gang, and Hacksaw Jim Duggan will take on the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. It is my sincere wish that all of the participating wrestlers in this historic tournament, and more importantly, all of the fans of the World Wrestling Federation, construe my decision as the only just and fair way to determine who will be the new undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion. Thank you.
Team partner Terry Gibbs and Powers and Roma are really coming on strong as of late.
Well, the first thing I'd like to clear up, am I allowed to talk this week?
Of course you're allowed to talk this week. Everyone is. And boy, do we have a lot to talk about.
Yeah, well, it's about time. It's a good thing I called my attorney. Otherwise, I still wouldn't be talking with
you. You don't think so? Well, let me ask you this.
Ask me.
Do you know who's officiating this match?
Dave Hefner, the same man that officiated the big match between Andre and Hogan.
No. The same man who was scheduled to, but his imposter, a look-alike Dave Hefner, was the man who officiated the Hogan-Andre match. This Dave Hefner has been fingerprinted, and I can assure you that Dave Hefner, one of the finest referees in the World Wrestling Federation today, is above and beyond reproach.
Yeah, that's what they figured. That's what they figured in the last match. How can you tell that that's Dave Hefner?
Because he's been fingerprinted, and now, before he goes out, because of the chicanery of the Million Dollar Man,
wait.
This man is Jeff, and Jeff thoroughly.
Wait just a minute, McMahon. I would say that that's a 50-50 deal. Why are you necessarily feeling that Hulk Hogan has told the truth?
Oh, come on, Jesse. That's ridiculous.
Hey,
look at that.
It's word against word, McMahon. Word against word.
I understand that, and I'm sure that was one of the reasons why Jack Tunney was forced, actually, to make the decision that he did to vacate the title. Ted DiBiase must be beside himself that he is no longer champion. Look at this. Two and three. The shoulders squarely down on the mat. Referee Dave Hefner gives the victory to the young Stallion. The Stallion is victorious.
The team of the young Stallion.
The Stallion victorious, and there is a look at a little Hulkamaniac, and I can tell you the little Hulkamaniacs are behind the big Hulkster now more than ever. Let's take you to the interview.
By now, you've heard the astonishing pronouncement of World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney. World Championship is being held up for the time being, but certainly things may be ironed out when WrestleMania 4 happens in Atlantic City at the Trump Plaza on Sunday afternoon, March 27th, with a 4 p.m. start. There will be an elimination tournament for the World Wrestling Federation's heavyweight title. Quite obviously, Hulk Hogan, Andre the Giant, receiving byes, and justifiably so. In the first round, however, other top contenders will meet in various brackets in that first round, including this man, by virtue of all that he's done at the World Wrestling Federation over the past 3 years, Macho Man Randy Savage. You're going to be part of this big tournament, and your opponent in the first round is going to be none other than the Natural Butch Reed. First of all, what do you make of all that's happened over the past week, 10 days?
I'm going to answer your second question first.
I like that.
Yeah, WrestleMania 4 with all the focus and attention going right there to that one place in time. Yeah, I'm talking to you, Natural Butch Reed, right now, looking into the video scope. I got respect for you as an athlete, super athlete, but you don't have the only key to the gym, yeah. There's other people that have paid their dues, and that focus of attention at WrestleMania 4 four is gonna be spectacular, a spectacle, yeah. But, yeah, go ahead, right
you
now,
know, Macho
yeah.
Man Randy Savage, it's no secret, in late 1987, you were proclaimed to be one half of the Mega Powers along with Hulk Hogan. What do you make of what has happened to Hulk Hogan and the World Heavyweight Championship?
That question right there is too hot to handle right now.
What's
yeah,
up?
I'm thinking I hear voices, but my eyes don't lie. Yeah, and you know what I'm talking about, Ted DiBiase. Yeah, this'll carry you a little ways, but it won't take you all the way. Yeah, you're gonna be taught that sometime in your life. And I think WrestleMania 4 can be the place. Yeah, but Butch Natural Reed, I'm talking the guy with the big guns. Yeah, that's the guy I'm concentrating on. Yeah, WrestleMania 4, I'll be there and ready. Yeah.
All right, he is one of the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation in WrestleMania 4 in the tournament for the world title, the Macho Man. To me,
the Slickster. Nobody moves in that ring like the Slickster. Check him out.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
And he represents.
And of course, you can see the Natural Butcher. He is a real powerhouse, this man.
The Natural
Natural Butch Reed before this capacity crowd.
From the state of Florida.
Look at that Slickster moving out there, McMahon. Bruno, can you quick step like that?
Nope. No way. I don't think Rex King is all that impressed with the movements thus far of Butch Reed. He might be more impressed after the music stops, though. Natural Butch Reed getting ready to lock up with Rex King. Butch Reed very well could be the next World Wrestling Federation champion. He's part of that tournament that Tony announced earlier on.
Yeah, that tournament. I'll tell you what I feel about that. To me, it's just Jack Tunney avoiding the issue. That's his way of getting out of
it. Avoiding the issue, if anything, I think he met the issue headlong. And as he stated earlier on, I believe that he did the only just...
Andre the Giant is the champion. If he's... give the title to Ted DiBiase, that's the champion's prerogative. As
hey,
as
once
I'm
you surrender that title, man, that's it.
Oh, you see Rex King there could be surrendering the match after that. Rex King up to the top rope with a move that indeed could cost him the matchup. We had an occasion to talk with the Natural earlier on. Here's what Butch Reed had to say.
WrestleMania 4. The Natural Man goes down one more time. Macho Man Randy Savage, you got the diamond stepping with the first round of Natural Man. Well, come on and see what a real man does to a boy like you.
And the Natural in the tournament of champions, so to speak, at WrestleMania. We're meeting, of course, the Macho Man Randy Savage. Take a look at that.
And I'll tell you something, McMahon. If the Natural gets the Macho Man, I know the Macho Man is great at airborne tactics.
Yeah.
But if Butch Reed picks the Macho Man up like that, Macho Man may be out of the running for the world title.
Indeed, he just could very well be, as Butch Reed collars his opponent, Rex King, spins him over, and that's an easy victory for the Natural. The Natural Butch Reed victorious.
You know,
demolishing Rex King. What?
I like his press technique. He covers the man in poses. That takes style.
The Natural Butch Reed looking forward to his participation in WrestleMania, squaring off against the Macho Man Randy Savage in one of the six opening matches in the first round of the tournament. Right now, let's take you to a special interview.
All right, get ready for WrestleMania 4. Yes, it's going to be happening from Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino, Atlantic City, New Jersey. Sunday afternoon, March the 27th, 4 p.m. Eastern start. Come on in, Doctor of Style Slick. After what happened on the main event, officials of the World Wrestling Federation coming up with a championship elimination. We've got a couple of rounds for certain. Opening round, of course, obviously Hulk Hogan, Andre the Giant have drawn buys, but you got two good chances out of all of the top contenders, Slick.
Exactly. And understand that it's not an accident, brother.
Brother?
That's right. It's not an accident. You see, I planned it like that. That's why I've got the best mind in professional wrestling today.
The best mind?
Exactly.
All right.
Well, now,
please.
I want to bring in my two superstars.
One being the Natural Butch Reed, the other, the one-man gang. Gang here is going to be facing Bam Bam Bigelow in the first round very formidable opposition.
Well, you know what? Everybody's been talking about this is going to be a battle of the buds, a battle of the big men. But you know what, Bam Bam? When you step in the ring against the 747, baby, you just seem like a big man. Because this man is so big that every time he steps on the scale, it reads to be continued.
All right. Please, give me a break.
Right.
What about the natural Butch Reed facing Macho Man Randy Savage?
Let me tell you about the Macho Man Savage facing the natural Butch Reed, you understand? His chances is slim and none. And you know what happened to Slim? Slim just left town, baby. And they tell me that I might face who is that, Steamboat or Greg the Hammer Valentine? Well, let me tell you something, boys. It don't matter which one of you I had to face after that first round, because I'm going to face one of you. So let me tell you, Greg the Hammer, you are gonna be the one getting hammered, boy. And Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, you gonna be getting steamrolled.
I think it better be first things first. Let's see what happens with the Macho Man in WrestleMania 4 at Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino, Sunday afternoon, March 27th in Atlantic City.
Baby.
Confrontation, as we take you now to footage from that confrontation, courtesy of Wrestling Challenge. It occurred just last week.
And the warrior! Oh, come on! Kick by Hercules!
Get him!
That may not be a smart maneuver on the part of Hercules Hernandez.
Ultimate Warrior back on his feet. Yeeks! Oh my goodness! Can you believe that?
He's charging the warrior! Hercules charging the warrior!
Ramming a moment ago, the chain around his throat. Now he has it around again! Hercules choking!
This official is calling for more help. I believe the warrior is on his feet in the ring. Yes, he is. Here goes the warrior. The warrior going after Hercules Hernandez. He has it. Warrior and Hercules going back to the dressing room area.
This contest is scheduled for...
Tell you what, Hercules may have a little bit more than he bargained for picking on the Ultimate Warrior.
Well, the only thing I can say, I guess, is a chain is just as strong as its weakest link, right, man?
Well, you got that right.
Oh, take a look at this man!
I got an interesting question. Maybe you and Bruno can answer this for me. I mean, I doubt it, but I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. Duggan carries this huge two-by... Look at that face. Can you imagine that? He carries this huge two-by-four around. Now, everybody knows wrestlers travel all over the world, right?
Of course.
You're telling me this guy carries this 2x4 on the plane with him? Does he pack it in a bag? I mean, who travels around with a 2x4? You find that a little strange?
Who travels around with a snake?
I can understand a snake a little more. That's a pet. You know, that's something living and live.
Mm-hmm. Well, in any event, Hacksaw Jim Duggan takes over right from the start. Oh, my, yeah, he's in good shape. He may be in good shape for WrestleMania, too. Here's what he had to say.
He may be the million-dollar man to a lot of people, but he's just a nickel-and-dime dude to me. Ted DiBiase, you're a great wrestler, but you're going to have to fight Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and that's a fight you can win, tough guy.
Oh! Hacksaw Jim Duggan looking forward to his participation, squaring off against the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, in the first round of the World Wrestling Federation Championship Tournament as part of WrestleMania. And Jesse, wouldn't it be fitting if a man like this became World Wrestling Federation champion? Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Personally, I think it would be a disgrace. I think it'd be the worst champion since Bruno.
What? What do you mean by that?
What do I mean by it? Look at this guy.
Jealousy.
Second question out there. Now, which Dave Hebner is that in the ring?
If you see a Dave Hebner in the future, you can bet it is the only Dave Hebner, the only legitimate Dave Hebner, because his credentials are checked many, many times now. He's been fingerprinted. There will be no more chicanery from the million-dollar man, no more look-alike Dave Hebners. I assure you of that.
I was just going to say, if Hogan can pull it off once, he certainly could probably do it again.
I don't think the million-dollar man would attempt that again.
Whoa, there's that clothesline.
Did you see that clothesline?
Yes, indeed. Wow. It's all over.
Here is the
now, ladies and gentlemen, right after the ring announcement.
Jim Duggan!
There it is. Oh, come on, Jesse, get with the program. Come on. Let's take you to Andre the Giant, the million-dollar man, bodyguard Virgil and Mean Gene.
What an incredibly profound pronouncement from World Wrestling Federation President, the distinguished Jack Tunney. We now know that all leads up to Atlantic City, New Jersey, and WrestleMania 4 on Sunday afternoon, March the 27th, 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time start. And what a day and afternoon and evening
it's
going
to be.
Yeah,
what a day and afternoon it's going to be. I thought I had seen it all when Hogan brought out a look-alike referee to try to confuse the issue because he knew he was going to get beat. Now you, Tunney, you go in here and you got to mix up and mix it all up. Another loopholes, more bureaucratic crap. That's what it is. This man did his job. He pinned you, Hogan, 1, 2, 3, and delivered the belt to me. It should be right here around my waist. Bought and paid for. That's why I did it, to prove that it could be done, and it's exactly what I did. Now we're going to have a tournament. A tournament for a belt that I paid a lot of money for that I should already have. Well, you're number one, Duggan, on my hit list. All you people out there want to know that what the million-dollar man's made of? I've rolled over everybody else. And you, Duggan, you're just like all those penny-pinching nickel-and-dime peons out there. You've got no class. You don't belong in the ring with me, and I will pin you. I will make you submit. I will do whatever I gotta do, but that belt is gonna be mine.
All right, thank you, Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase. He's gonna be active in the first round in WrestleMania 4 of this elimination when he meets Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Andre the Giant, you and Hulk Hogan have received byes. However, the two of you will meet in the second round.
That's gonna be an easy match, because Hogan, you know it. I beat you 3 times already, and it's gonna be another 4 times. And Hogan, believe me, that belt gonna be in Ted DiBiase's waist. That's what I promise you that.
All right, the promise of Andre the Giant. Let's get ready for WrestleMania 4. Trump Plaza, Atlantic City, Sunday afternoon, March 27th.
I know it.
Comments made a few moments ago by the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase. Well, what can I say? He certainly found out that you cannot buy the World Wrestling Federation title. If, in fact, he is ever to become the legitimate champion, he must do it the old-fashioned way.
Matilda out there.
You know why she's not out there, Jesse, come on.
No, I don't.
You know what she's been going through.
What? I understood she lost
weight.
She lost some weight. What's the matter with that? That dog was fat and overweight to begin with.
She was not.
Wouldn't hurt her a bit.
She was not. British Bulldog.
She loses weight, she can get in Play Dog Magazine, maybe.
Play Dog Magazine. I think I've missed that one somewhere. British Bulldogs. Former tag team champions, as Davey Boy, I believe, start things off with the Red Demon.
And I just wonder, who might the Red Demon be?
I don't know.
You know, it always interests me why somebody will go under a mask. You know, is the guy too ugly? He doesn't want anyone, obviously, to know who he is or whatever.
I'm not too sure. Bruno, did you ever wear a mask?
No, I never wore a mask.
Yeah, maybe you should have, Bruno.
Oh, come on now. Wait a minute. That's not very nice. Demon right back and... Oh! Way up. Davey Boy Smith with a Demon way up in the air. Oh, and down to the canvas.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I can't take nothing away from Davey Boy Smith. He's a powerful, powerful man, and that ring is his proof right there.
Demon down once again. And Dynamite Kid in control this time.
You know what interests
me? Watch this. Snap suplex coming up, I think. Yes, look at that.
Yeah,
no one does it any better.
Very impressive move. But you know what interests me? I've heard all the crying, all the whining about the Bulldogs haven't got Matilda. They haven't been able to wrestle right since Matilda. This and that. I'll be interested to see when Matilda comes back if they're really going to improve because of it.
I'm told Matilda could be back very, very soon. She has really gained some weight as of late. And apparently her appetite, of course, has returned, and she's spunky, and she's happy. And I think we're going to see Matilda
very, very soon. And I think we owe a lot of that, Bruno, to the cards and letters that fans have been writing at.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. I mean, they got hundreds of thousands of letters. And I'll tell you something else. So look at the Bulldogs. You can see the difference even in them from now, from before, because they seem happy. Absolutely.
Wait, just look at these guys. You're telling me that that dog got better because people wrote in cards and letters? That dog can read?
She would be right there if it were not for the Islanders and Bobby Heenan. I'll tell you that.
You didn't answer my question.
Getting ready. Wait a minute. There's a tag there, and power slam. As now Dynamite is tagged in. Look at this from way up above. Boom!
About strength. Watch the power of Smith here as he presses Dynamite Kid, shoots him up like a feather. Look at this. Talk about strength. But now look at this as he torpedoes down on his. Ooh, look. Oh, my goodness. That's his
impressive. We'll be right
imagine opponents when they walk into that ring and have to stare across at Mr. Fuji and Mr. Fuji.
Yeah, that might be a little scary. Action smash. Action on the right. Smash on the left.
Eric Cooper. His partner from Tucson, Arizona, Dave Dudemeyer.
Dudemeyer and Cooper teaming up, I believe, for the first time. They're at a handicap.
I don't envy these two guys.
You don't, huh?
Not a bit. Not a bit.
I'd like to get your comments, Jesse, on if you disagree with Jack Tunney and his actions in proclaiming the title vacant and proclaiming this tournament to happen at WrestleMania. What would you have done if you had been Jack Tunney?
Well, I suppose, let me put it to you this way. Maybe there is some long-lost rule that a person can't give the title to another person. But to me, Andre the Giant's the champion. The referee made the decision.
Wait a minute.
Counted 1, 2, 3.
Did you not hear Andre the Giant say, "I surrender the championship"?
Definitely.
Okay, fine.
Fine. And there's some little loophole that probably Hulk Hogan found, took it to Jack Tunney's attention, and that's where we're at now. Total turmoil. We have no champion.
I don't know about total turmoil. We're going to sort it all out at WrestleMania. Demolition had a few comments earlier on.
Mr. Fuji has taught us very well. Every opponent we have faced, we have destroyed. We have demolished. Fight axe.
We're not asking, Strike Force. We're demanding. Nobody else is standing except you. We want the belts.
And I'll tell you something, McMahon. I do believe Strike Force is in deep trouble.
Oh,
because
really?
Those two pretty boys, how are they going to stand up to these two guys?
I don't know. It would be interesting.
You know, I'm taking nothing from Strike Force. They're the champions. They're great wrestlers. They're quick. They're pretty. They're good looking.
And that's why they'll stand up to these guys, for those reasons you just mentioned, Jesse.
Because they're pretty and good-looking.
No, because they're fast, they're good wrestlers, great condition, and they know every trick in that ring.
I'll tell you what, if Strike Force ends up in that, you can have these champions, definitely.
Well, it'll be all over for them if they end up that way, but the trick is not to end up that way.
Here are your winners, Demolition!
Axe and Smash, the Banding. A World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Title Matchup.
Look at this. Here comes, who is it, Max?
Max.
Actually, look at that. With all the 300-pound pound weight. Wow, Cooper is out.
In just one moment, we shall take you to a most interesting interview.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, with the status of the World Wrestling Federation's Heavyweight Championship, that coinciding with the announcement of Sunday afternoon, March 27th, in Atlantic City, New Jersey, Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino, WrestleMania 4. I cannot believe that these decisions have been made by the World Wrestling Federation, but I must say, justice justice will prevail. You've got this big elimination comprised of nothing but number one contenders. Our president, Jack Tunney, justifiably so, giving Andre the Giant and Hulk Hogan a bye in the first round. Here are the first round matches in this elimination tournament that will be for the World Wrestling Federation's Heavyweight Championship. First round, Jake the Snake Roberts to meet Ravishing Rick Rude. Bam Bam Bigelow and the One-Man Gang to meet. Also in WrestleMania 4 in the first round of the elimination tournament, Don Morocco to meet Canadian strongman Dino Bravo. Hacksaw Jim Duggan to meet the much talked about and very controversial million-dollar man Ted DiBiase. Steamboat Valentine, Savage and Reed. Those are all first round. Look at your eyes, Hulk Hogan. I can see the pain. I can feel it just standing next to you.
How much money, brother, did the multi-million dollar man lay on the dude to have his face redone? How much did he lay in that plastic surgery? How much extra man to rip me off of the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight title? You know, I feel justice is giving us all our due, man, because the foundation of the prayers, the vitamins, and training the largest arms in the world. We're not going to have to go after number one contender after number one contender, man. I feel because the way we've lived this thing, we're getting paid back big time. Thank God for Donald Trump. Thank God for Trump Plaza. Thank God for the WWF and Jack Tunney. Because on this one given night, WrestleMania 4, we can weed through all the trash and get right down to the basics. Either it's a multi-million dollar man, either it's Andre the Giant, or if by hook or by crook, that skinny Virgil happens to wind up with me in WrestleMania 4, we're going to prove Hulkamania lives forever, and we're the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion.
All right, I thank you, Hulk Hogan, WrestleMania 4 in Atlantic City, March 27th.
Bam Bigelow squaring off against the mighty Sika. And then from there, the WrestleMania 4 report announcing yet more matches and more stars to come. We'll hear also more from the one and only Andre the Giant, and then this match, the ultimate warrior